Hello everybody, in this video we are going to look at the accounting treatment for forfeiture and reissue of shares. This is a small introduction about me. This is about my specialization in teaching and research. If you like the video, you can subscribe after watching the video. Let us have a quick look at the problem. A company forfeits 100 shares of 10 rupees each, originally issued at a premium of 2 rupees per share. So 10 plus 2, the issue price per share is 12. The shareholder paid 4 rupees per share on application, but did not pay the allotment money of 4 rupees per share, including premium. So this 4 rupees allotment money includes 2 rupees of premium as well, and call money of 4 rupees per share. Therefore, the shareholder is paid only the application money of 4 rupees per share on the 100 shares he is allotted with, whereas he failed to pay the allotment money of 2 plus 2 plus the call money of 4 rupees per share. So out of the 12 rupees called for, he has paid only 4 rupees. Therefore, the remaining 8 rupees, 4 rupees on application and 4 rupees of call money, he has failed to pay. The shares were subsequently reissued, forfeited and reissued at 11 rupees per share as fully paid up. Here, this is something unusual. Normally, the forfeited shares will be reissued at a price less than the par value. Here, the par value of a share is 10 rupees, but here might be a popular company. Therefore, even in the reissue of the forfeited shares, the shares have been issued at a price which is higher than that of the par value. Past journal entries for forfeiture and reissue of the forfeited shares. Please look at the journal entry. Let me explain in my style. See, in this journal, whatever you called for per share, that is what called up value per share. Totally, we have called up 12 rupees per share. 10 is the par value. 2 rupees of securities premium per share, totally we have called for 12 rupees per share from the shareholder. That would be debited here. Whatever he has not paid the allotment money of 4 rupees per share, he has not paid the call money of 4 rupees per share, that would be credited. Followed by what he has already paid per share, and that will also be credited. This is the structure of the journal entry for share forfeiture. And look at the journal. Share capital account debited 100 shares into 10 rupees, that's a called up value, till the time of forfeiture. Till the time of forfeiture, that is 10 rupees is a called up value, excluding premium. Make it very simple, excluding premium. So 100 into 10, 1000 rupees. Then securities premium account debited 100 into 2, it comes to 200 rupees. These two have been called up per share, for the 100 shares, and therefore they have been debited. Moreover, the share premium which was not collected along with the allotment money has to be reversed. That is the idea behind this journal. In the original allotment entry, it would have been credited. If you recall, you can very well find out, that particular share allotment account debtor, two share capital, two securities premium, you would have done the entry in this way. And the credited securities premium which was credited in the entry has to be reversed, and that is what done here. And the next one, what is it he has not paid? Share allotment he has not paid. So that is the originally which was debited is now reversed and credited. Two share allotment, 100 into 4, 400 rupees. Two share call, 100 into 4, 400 rupees. These two are unpaid. And what is that he has paid? Two share forfeiture, he paid only application money. And therefore, two share forfeiture account, 100 shares into 4, 400 rupees. So 100 shares were forfeited for non-payment of allotment and call money. Now the entry for reissue of the 100 shares. Bank account debtor, debit what comes in. When money comes in, it has to be debited. So bank account debtor, 100 into 11 rupees, it comes to 1100. To share capital account, 100 into 10 rupees, because the premium, if any, has to be separated. It cannot be mixed up with the capital. So to share capital account, 100 into 10, it comes to 1000. To securities premium, what is that securities premium here? The par value of the share is 10 rupees, whereas it has been reissued at the rate of 11. The 1 rupee extra which the company has collected in the reissue of the forfeited share is treated as premium. This is a peculiar situation. So to securities premium, 100 into 1. So the forfeited shares were reissued at a premium of 1 rupee per share. Now, once the forfeited shares are reissued, the forfeiture account on such shares cannot be maintained by the company. So the residual amount, or you know, the balance amount in the share forfeiture account of the forfeited shares, have to be transferred to capital reserve account. Here, since there is no loss on reissue of the forfeited shares, the entire share forfeiture amount of 400 rupees has to be transferred to capital reserve. So share forfeiture account debtor, because it's originally credited, you know, if you look at, you know, the first journal entry, the, you know, share forfeiture account is what? It is credited. Now it has, when it is transferred, it has to be debited. That is what the real idea behind double entry system of bookkeeping. Fine. So share forfeiture account debtor 400, 100 into 4, to capital reserve account 400, the residual amount on the forfeiture account transferred to capital reserve account. And in the coming videos, I will release, you know, videos, you know, on accounting one after other. In the coming videos, I will try to increase the complication slowly. And kindly watch, you know, the videos and learn this particular topic very effectively. Thanks for watching this video.